What is up, everyone? 2022 is here. Hope you all have a healthy, successful, a much better year. And as you guys saw the thumbnail of this video, I'm starting off my year with a bang. And in today's video, I'll be unboxing some epic speakers by KRIX. And as you guys can see, I'm very, very excited to share this with you guys, as I'll be using some of them for my existing mini man cave and some for my upcoming dedicated home theater room. If you enjoy entertaining casual home theater content, you know what to do. Hit that thumbs up button for me. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more weekly videos. If you're in the market for some epic in-wall or box type speakers, before you pull the plug on anything, stick around because you need to see what I'm about to show you. It's gonna be fun. All right, so I like to keep my videos nice and short, so I'm going to jump straight into one of the biggest reveals of my upcoming dedicated home theater room, the surround and the surround back channels. Without giving away too much, the room measures at a very similar size to my previous room with a slight minor change of layout, which of course I'll share with you guys when the time is right. But as you guys can see here, I have four KRIX speakers, which are the Symmetrix in-wall speakers that I personally think they look gorgeous and sound phenomenal without breaking the bank. It does retail for $695 Australian dollars each and can of course be also used as front speakers designed to fit into a standard 70mm stud wall. And as you guys can see, it's slim and yet elegant. It also of course comes with a standard white, very thin, rust resistant stainless steel magnetic grille like most competitive brands, which can be easily painted to match your wall color of your choice. I just love how this speaker looks. We're silently gridded with a pair of 4-inch dope paper cone woofers with a 1-inch dual concentric high frequency driver in the center, with of course two front facing bass reflex ports. Turning the speaker around, here is something a little different compared to some other competitive brands. The enclosed rear cabinet, which is designed to guarantee the best possible bass performance and minimize sound transferring into other rooms. I really like this. Cannot miss the KRIX logo, of course. And lastly, to the bottom is your gold-plated spring terminals for quick and easy installation. Excuse the shortcut, I'm just going to quickly unbox the rest. The entire speaker weighs about 4 kilograms, which is approximately 9 lbs. It measures out 211 wide by 596 in height with a 79mm mounting depth. It is a 6-ohm speaker that produces up to 140 watts RMS, which is pretty awesome for an 89 dB in-wall speaker. Like I mentioned in my socials, both of my home theater rooms will feature full KRIX setups, so that rules out the comparison with other brands. But if you're a big fan of KRIX, just like myself, you'd know there are many other in-wall options, such as the new budget Ecliptics, which looks great, and the high-end Epix in-wall speaker, the Scenics, the Beastie Phonics, and of course the Megaphonics that you guys have seen me use the on-wall version in my previous home theater room. Once again, I chose these specific speakers according to my budget, and I think the really long narrow shape will hide nicely behind things like decorative columns, acoustic panels, and even possibly make installation a lot easier, avoiding things like in-wall stud cutouts. I just love how all of these in-wall speaker names end in IX. I guess that's what makes the brand KRIX so unique. Unique. Moving along. The speaker looks bigger than what it measures. I love the finished matte color, which should blend in nicely in the new room. Looks professional, aesthetically looks so neat, and like I mentioned earlier, it does not break the bank and comes with 5-year warranty like most speakers from KRIX, which is very, very important for me. I cannot wait to hook this up in the near future. Stay tuned, let's move on to the next speaker. Now this is where things are gonna get a little interesting. I'm going to quickly unbox the center speaker, which is the Vortex MK2 in Blackwood cabinet finish to match the harmonic towers that I unboxed for you guys last week. This speaker of course will be used for my mini home theater room here in my rental home, but I do have a hiccup that I might just need your help with. Tell you guys about it in a moment. You beauty. Wow, I think I'm in love. Wifey, if you're watching this, I am so sorry, but damn, says it all. It does kind of remind me of the SVS Ultra Center speaker that has a very similar driver configuration, but I think that speaker weighs in about 14 kilograms. As for this beast, 24 kilograms. Wow. Now, just like my harmonics towers, this comes in a couple of different cabinet finishes. It measures out 230 high by 725 wide and 370mm deep, which is possibly the biggest center channel speaker I've owned to date. With a retail price of 1745 Australian dollars, this 6 ohm semi-sensitive speaker of 91 dB handles up to 250 watts RMS. I think that's really impressive, and believe it or not, this three-way design is based on the highly successful Harmonix MK2 towers, which delivers vocal clarity, mid-range depth, and dynamic bass response. Face on, once again, the drivers are identical to the KRIX floor standing Harmonix MK2 main speakers. On either end, next to them, bass reflex vents, it features two 6.5-inch laminated polypropylene cones with a 1/4-inch voice coil with aluminum flux stabilization ring for low distortion. Towards the middle, the bottom driver is a dedicated 5-inch mid-range normally coated paper cone with a 1-inch dual concentric tweeter on top. The vertical design works great and it eliminates phasing problems if you're seated off axis, making sure every seat in the room is a good one. There is really not much else to it other than to the back, of course, are the dual gold-plated bi-wire binding posts. Some guys will be questioning, why don't LCR speakers have spring-loaded terminals instead? Well, the spring-loaded terminals, you don't have the option to bi-wire or bi-amp your speakers. Simple. I am honestly loving this center speaker. Its craftsmanship is beautiful. It's not massively too big or too small. Kind of the perfect combination for a small to medium-sized room. I'm sure it's going to look wild once I hook this up, but if you're enjoying this massive speaker haul video so far, give me a thumbs up on the video and stick around for the final look of my front stage area in the mini home theater room. That's coming up in a few moments. If any of you guys are in the market for a center speaker, honestly, check these out. If you have any questions, I'm happy to answer them. Comment, email me, DM me, whichever is easy for you guys. Moving on to our last unboxing, and by reading the box, these are the KRIX Equinox MK3 surround speakers for my room to complete my 5-channel speaker setup. Let's get to it. When I first heard these, I was so surprised and actually punches well above its weight. So don't be so fooled on how small these guys are. They're deceptively compact and ideal for a 2-channel hi-fi system, but can also be used on stands as rear or side surround speakers. It measures at 175 wide by 235 deep and 295mm in height, weighing in at about a cute 6 kilograms, but definitely has some underrated power and clarity, which handles up to 120 watts RMS. Matching my setup, of course, it is a 6 ohm speaker with a sensitivity of 88 dB, retails for about 1245 Australian dollars in the blackwood finish, so it's fairly reasonable for a speaker that has no competition in its class. Alright, so as you guys can see, this two-way speaker features a 5-inch curvilinear papercone woofer with, of course, the same 1-inch tweeter as the center speaker that's right at the top. One thing that's a little different is the bass reflex vents, which is right at the back, not at the front. From what I know, these tweeters combined with the bass reflex design produces an efficient but very well balanced high-end sound for its size. Overall, they look elegant and yet has bad boy written all over it. Definitely grills off for me when they're in use, but most definitely grills on when the kids are around. Some of you guys know how painful that can be. That being said, the time has come to install these beauties and take a closer look at the finished product. Follow me. All right, so of course, this is my mini home theater room for now. Them Harmonix towers looking and sounding astonishing so far. And what a way to finish off my setup with this monster. So as I mentioned earlier about being in a pickle, here it is. This TV has been with me for some time now, and the original stand, of course, was some fancy looking thing that took out this entire space. I bought this adjustable TV extender from Amazon to shift the TV up, make some room for the center speaker area, but as you guys can see, that still was not enough. Some of you might be thinking, why not just wall mount the TV, suckers? Well, unfortunately, I cannot because this is a rental home. I think I really have no other options at this stage. In fact, it's not so bad because I mostly watch movies that have the top and bottom black bars anyway. But if you guys have any suggestions, drop a comment for me. Do you have a similar issue due to space and cabinetry? Let me know your thoughts. The Equinox speakers, on the other hand, are sitting on my speaker stands perfectly. I'm going to use a bit of chewing gum. Ah, that's disgusting. This is the famous blue tack that I like to use to hold the speakers in place. You can also use Velcro if you like, just in case the kids accidentally bump it. We don't want a man down. They're sitting slightly on the corners of my viewing point, so I've tilted them approximately 45 degrees to get the best sound possible. And yeah, that's about it for now. Take a look around. Hope you guys like it. Let me know what you would change or add in this room. Any feedback is greatly appreciated. Well, that sums up pretty much of today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this epic speaker haul unboxing and showcase. I'm almost there with this room with some final minor adjustments left, so make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can be notified when the full room tour drops. If any of you guys have any questions about these speakers or the room itself, don't be shy, shoot a comment down below and I'll do my best to reply as soon as I can. In the meantime, I hope you kick off the year with a positive banger. Stay safe. And as always, you'll catch me in the next one. Time for you to get out.